Discussion on coronary angiographic views. Coronary angiography is done in multiple projections or views to get a three-dimensional idea of the coronary lesions. Some regions of the coronary arteries may appear foreshortened in certain views so that true length of the lesion may not be appreciated. Actual severity of eccentric stenosis can be ascertained only by multiple orthogonal views. Even though there are several conventional views for coronary angiography, unusual angulations may be needed in an individual case to guide coronary interventions. Often, a test shot is given before the actual cine run to see if the branches are overlapping or not. Common projections used in coronary angiography are left anterior oblique LAO, right anterior oblique RAO, postero-anterior PA or AP, and lateral views. In addition to these, varying degrees of cranial or caudal angulations can be added to these views. In general, proximal parts of major vessels are best seen in caudal projections. We will discuss the views for left coronary angiography now. Spider view or LAO caudal view is often the first view taken during coronary angiography. This view is useful in visualizing the left main coronary artery and its bifurcation into left anterior descending coronary artery and left circumflex coronary artery. LAO angulation may vary from 40 to 50 degrees and caudal angulation 25 to 40 degrees. LAO caudal view of left coronary angiogram resembles a spider and hence the term spider view. LMCA, left main coronary artery. LCX, left circumflex coronary artery. Lesion in LCX marked by yellow arrow. LAD, left anterior descending coronary artery. Early OM, early obtuse marginal branch of the LCX. From the LMCA bifurcation, LAD is seen towards the catheter side and LCX towards the opposite side in this view. Dye or contrast reflux into the aorta from the LMCA is seen. Absence of dye reflux would mean left main ostial disease or rarely spasm. This is a left coronary angiogram in LAO caudal view in another case. JL, Judkin's left coronary catheter. Difference in the orientation of coronaries could be due to anatomical variations as well as mild changes in angulations used. X-ray penetration will be less in LAO caudal view, especially in obese individuals. In this view, mid-segment of LAD is foreshortened and hence this view should not be used during angioplasty of mid-LAD. But proximal region of LAD is visualized well. Proximal and mid-segments of LCX are well seen in this view. Video of left coronary angiogram in LAO caudal view is shown here with annotation of branches in a still frame. RAO caudal view is another common view for the left coronary angiogram. Some operators use this as the first view. Usual angulation is 30 to 40 degrees to the right, but shallower views may be used sometimes to reduce respiratory movements. Sufficient caudal angulation to separate out the proximal portions of the LAD and LCX is used. Proximal and mid portions of LCX and bifurcation of marginal branches are seen. It is a good view for the distal LAD. Diagonal and septal branches may superimpose on the proximal and mid LAD in this view. Left coronary angiogram in RAO caudal view showing a tight lesion in the obtuse marginal branch of the left circumflex coronary artery. LAD, left anterior descending coronary artery. The OM lesion is marked by the blue arrow and is seen in the proximal portion of the obtuse marginal, which is a major branch of the left circumflex. This is a left coronary angiogram in RIO caudal view from another case. Distal LAD is seen well in this case. Diagonal and septal branches are overlapping the mid LAD as mentioned earlier. PA cranial view is ideal for most lesions in the proximal and mid LAD. A cranial angulation of 40 degrees shows the diagonal and septal branches in opposite directions well separated from the LAD. Left coronary angiogram in PA cranial view showing a proximal plaque marked by an arrow in LAD. In this case, a recanalized vessel after anterior wall myocardial infarction. Septal and diagonal branches of LAD are also seen. Almost the whole extent of the LAD is seen well. Proximal left circumflex is foreshortened in this view. Rightward angulation, RIO cranial, is useful in reducing the overlap of proximal LAD by the vertebral spine and the catheter. It may be noted that in both cranial views, the diaphragmatic shadow goes high up into the field. Video of left coronary angiogram in RIO cranial view showing a complex lesion in the LAD. The LAD can be seen wrapping around the apex. Type 3 LAD. In type 1 LAD, it will stop short of the apex and type 2 will reach up to the apex. LAO cranial view straightens out the proximal and mid LAD. Diagonal branches are seen on the same side as the obtuse marginal branches. Septal perforators are seen to the opposite side. In this left coronary angiogram in LAO cranial view, OM branches of LCX are seen overlapping the spine. Diagonals are seen running down between the spine and the LAD. Septal branches are seen on the opposite side but almost parallel to the LAD. Lateral view is seldom used and ideally requires the positioning of the hands above the head to avoid superimposition of patient's arms. But this requirement is not there when the field of interest is in the distal part of the LAD, which is anterior. The same applies to visualization of the anastomosis between the left internal mammary artery and LAD. Lima to LAD coronary bypass graft in lateral view. The image has been darkened a bit by post-processing to visualize the lima and LAD well. Since it was an injection into the left subclavian artery just near the lima ostium, the contrast density was a bit lower than that of a superselective lima injection. The sternal wires indicate the post-sternotomy status. Distal flow into the LAD is good. Retrograde flow from the anastomotic site into the proximal part of LAD is also seen. Now we will move on to views for right coronary artery. RIO view shows the conus branch and sinus node artery in opposite directions as seen in this image. Right ventricular branches and posterior descending artery are seen well. Multiple septal branches can be seen arising from the PDA. PDA has a mild lesion in the proximal portion. In the angiogram illustrated, the posterior left ventricular branch is occluded and only a stump, PLV stump, is seen. Atrioventricular nodal artery usually originates near the bifurcation of the right coronary artery into PDA and PLV. Here is another right coronary angiogram in RIO view. Here the septal branches of PDA and PLV are seen well. RIO view shows the proximal part of the right coronary artery in a vertical line. RIO view is identified with the spine seen on the right side. Tight stenosis is seen just before the origin of right ventricular branch. LAO view usually shows the full length of the right coronary artery in a C shape. Distally, the right coronary artery divides into PDA and PLV at the crux caudis. Crux caudis is the junction of the atrioventricular and interventricular grooves posteriorly. The artery which crosses the crux is defined as the dominant coronary artery. Right coronary dominance is much more common than left dominance. Even when the right coronary artery is dominant, the major portion of left ventricular myocardium is supplied by the left coronary artery. PA cranial view of right coronary angiogram is shown here. As in other cranial views, diaphragmatic contour can be seen high up in the field. A tight lesion is seen in proximal portion of PDA marked as 1. PLV, posterior left ventricular branch, AM, acute marginal branch, RCA, right coronary artery. Conus branch of the right coronary artery. Sometimes while cannulating the right coronary artery, the catheter slips into the conus artery. This causes wedging and damping of catheter tip pressure. Prolonged inadvertent injection of contrast into the conus branch can cause ventricular tachycardia or ventricular fibrillation occasionally. A large conus branch crossing the right ventricular outflow tract can cause problem during intracardiac repair of tetralogy of Fallot. LAO cranial view of right coronary angiogram using an amplex right catheter is shown here. This RCA was difficult to cannulate with Judkin's right catheter even after repeated attempts. The angiogram shows only minimal luminal irregularities of the RCA. Right ventricular branches are seen originating from the proximal region. Terminal branching of RCA into posterior left ventricular PLV or PLB branches and posterior descending coronary artery are also seen.